Now, traffic and weather together on Action News 8.
Good morning, everyone. We'll take a look at the low clouds via our night infrared image. Thank you, NASA, of course. They put these things up in space for us, and now we can see right through the night sky. We can see the gray. The marine layer is at about 2,000 feet, so it's come all the way inland and up some of the hills, of course, and it's going to be a while before we burn it off. And thankfully, we have that. Otherwise, we'd need the regular old AC, which is what they're going to be cranking everywhere east of the Mississippi. Look at these morning lows. I mean, holy cow, it's 90 in New York City right now. Feels more like about 99 when you add the humidity in. 88 in St. Louis, 77 in Chicago, 81 Atlanta. Look what's happening in the afternoon, though. This is the heat wave we've been talking about. 98 Denver, 100 St. Louis, 97 Dallas, 99 New York. Those are the temps. When you start adding in, though, the humidity with that, it's going to feel somewhere between 105 and 115 to the body. Very hard for people to cool off there because the humidity is so high. When you start to sweat, it doesn't evaporate off your skin, so the body just can't cool off. And that's why you have all kinds of heat warnings out there, excessive heat warnings, which basically means, you know what, you try not to go outside. If you are working outside, you take frequent breaks, lots of light-colored clothing, fluid, and all that. And that's a good thing to remember for here when we get some heat, too. Back west, of course, nothing but tranquil conditions. You can see a few thunderstorms in the afternoon, most of them actually heading towards Chicago's O'Hare Airport. So you may have a few airport delays there. Our bay forecast looking really nice, though, today. Look at this. We'll get a little breeze out on the bay, but not expecting more than 15 knots. And swells are running at about 3 to 5 feet. If you're heading offshore, maybe look for some albacore, of course, you'll run into about 4 to 6 feet. But outside of that, not a whole lot of surf, maybe about waist to chest high, if you're lucky. So not a lot of real swell in the water. 66 San Francisco, 80 in Redwood City. And as you head inland, of course, real nice. Plenty of 80s to go around from San Jose down to Gilroy. We'll put a 76 in for Hollister this afternoon. They catch that sea breeze quite nicely in the afternoon. 68 here in Salinas. Then you get into the 70s for Gonzales and Soledad, then 80s, Greenfield, King City, some 90s south of there. On the coast, of course, we certainly aren't going to be seeing 80s or 90s. How about middle and upper 60s, though? 73 in Carmel Valley, 71 in Big Sur. Nice day, though, and a nice weekend to head out to the MotoGP or, of course, the Salinas Rodeo. Should be great with cool conditions in the evening. 67 here in Salinas, in Santa Cruz this afternoon, 74 in Scotts Valley, and 78 in Boulder Creek. 7-day forecast is rain-free. The next warm-up doesn't happen until the middle or end of next week, so we'll stick with 70s and 80s inland with a few 90s south of King City and 60s and 70s at the coast.